Do you know what Islam says? It says that life's the greatest test. It says that life's a borrowed space, returned upon rest. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way.
كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد, dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, our topic of this evening, as the brother said, is know about your role models. And every ummah or every nation, every society has role models, dead or alive. And these people are those people who are role models and share with the nation that they represent and some or lots of values, and they hold the best level in that society when it comes to the values and manners and morals and the things that the nation or the society values. So as an ummah of Islam, or a nation of Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us Muslims. هو سماكم المسلمين من قبل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us Muslims from the beginning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent prophets to this ummah. So all the prophets were Muslims, alhamdulillah. So the first role models of the al-umma al-islamiyyah, or the nation of Islam, are the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are heavenly guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through revelation and wahy. And they received the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala either through Jibreel alayhi salam or directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, well, the Quran discusses and talks about the prophets, starting with Prophet Adam alayhi salam and ending with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the history of each prophet was mentioned, and some of them very much detailed in the Quran, in so many verses and so many surahs or chapters in the Quran. And including Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala characterized him that he is the best person when it comes to character and manners. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the last prophet. مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a father of your men, of one of you. He is not a father of one of you, or one of these men. He is not the father of that. وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. But he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the seal of the prophets. So, the prophets do not sin. They might make mistakes, but they do not sin. So alhamdulillah, we associate with them. They are our role models. They are our leaders in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are some qualities that we can never reach, or we can never compete. And those qualities are, one of these qualities, that they are ma'sumin. Ma'sumin means they are guarded and kept away from committing sins. But the rest of us, we do not have that guarantee. We do not have that protection 100% guaranteed. We are susceptible to dhunub, sins. And sometimes we're weak, and shaitan and our weak soul overpowers us to do bad things. We make mistakes, we do sin, and things come up. So the next level that we can associate more with, that have the same qualities that we have, are the followers of the prophets. Followers of the prophets. The Sahaba of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's one of the reasons and that I chose this topic for us. And there's another reason also. Quran discusses the history of the prophets, the seerah of the prophets. And there are distinguished books for the seerah or the history of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But we usually do not see that. History of the Sahaba, we don't see that much. So it is very important to know about the Sahaba, the followers of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another reason is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the explanation of the Quran. But how the Quran was practiced and how the Sunnah of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was practiced in a real life cannot be known or fully comprehend or understood except through the actions, understanding and application of the first generation of the Muslims, Ashabu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companions of the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's another reason as why we chose this topic. Another reason that this topic makes this topic very important is that today we are in a society and in a time that values are mixed. Priorities are not clear to many of us. Faith is weakened by the exposure to so many deviant groups and deviant role models that our young generation follows, whether they are basketball and players, soccer players, singers, movie stars, whatever they are, our young generation is after those people who they do not share almost no values with them. They do not share any values with them. And when you ask them about the early Muslims, the companions of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Umar ibn al-Khattab, Abdurrahman ibn Awf, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Uthman ibn Affan, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubair ibn al-Awwam, Sa'id ibn Zayd, Sa'd ibn Abu Waqqas, Usama ibn Zayd, and name them, the great, great Sahaba radhiyallahu anhu. When you ask them about those names, it's like they never heard of them. They never heard of them. And they will be asking you, who are those people you're talking about? Are they alive? Where do they live? Who are they? They have no idea. Although they're Muslims, alhamdulillah, may be praying. They might be praying 5 times a day. Might be reciting the Quran even. At least some juzus or some verse of the Quran or chapters. But they have no idea the history of this ummah. That's very important then, to teach this ummah their leaders, those who practiced the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their best ability. And those who, when they practiced the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best way, they reached the best level of humanity. The best level of humanity. In all terms of life. in terms of governance and good management, in terms of higher standard spiritualities, high standard spiritualities, in terms of understanding of their situation and their time, in terms of their unity and the unity of their message, in terms of their worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in terms of their kindness, mercy and love towards others, they were the best. They were the best. They succeeded in both worlds, in this world and in the afterworld. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was satisfied with them while they were still alive. And Quran was revealed, indicating the satisfaction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the approval of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of their deeds while they were still alive. لقد رضي الله عن المؤمنين إذ يبايعونك تحت الشجرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala satisfied with the mu'mineen, the faithful, when they are giving you the allegiance under the tree at Hudaybiyah, closer to Mecca. About 1400 men of the Sahaba, companions of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, some of them were even given the good news of going to the heaven, guaranteed and promised. They were promised and guaranteed to go to the heaven. We call those Ashara al-Asharatul Mubashirin, al-Mubashirin bil Jannah. Jannah was guaranteed for them while they were still alive. So in that sense, and in all sense of life, both spiritual and material, they were the best. They preached the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala successfully in their lifetime. They preached the risala, the message of Islam, and within 30 years they reached almost the known world at the time, almost many places. So they were the best. How did they become the best? What have they done to reach that level? What was their life about? How did they practice the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What kind of qualities they had and we don't have? These are the things that we might ask ourselves when we think and study and their stories, radwanullahi alayhim. So inshallah, we'll start with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When we say Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, if you talk about the Sahaba of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first comes first. They have levels. First comes first. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is the first. There is no dispute about that. So inshallah, we will go over and inshallah and the talking points of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. First, we will go about his biography. The simple things like his name and his nickname, where was he born, when was he born, and the fada'il and of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and Abu Bakr believing the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, immigration of Abu Bakr with the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the succession of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, that he succeeded the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how that happened. Abu Bakr and his knowledge radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr and his sadaqah or charity, Abu Bakr and his love of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr and the ayat or the verse of the Quran that talk about him, Abu Bakr and the guarantee of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him the Jannah, Abu Bakr and his characteristics and his position is in the battle of Uhud radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr and other Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, and what our scholars said about Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and finally Abu Bakr and his actions, what he did, his great achievements at the time of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and after time of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the zuhud of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and then the final days of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. So inshallah, if we don't finish and complete tonight all those things, inshallah we'll complete another night. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, his name is Abdullah ibn Uthman ibn Amir ibn Amr ibn Ka'b ibn Sa'ad ibn Taym ibn Murra ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay al-Qurashi al-Taymi. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, his name, he's an what we call an kunya. Kunya means when you are called by the name of your of your children, like Abu Bakr, the son, the father of Bakr. That's what it means, the father of Bakr. Sometimes it is the person is named like the father of his son or father of his daughter, and sometimes it's a name, but it might not be necessary that he has a daughter or son. So there is no known son for Abu Bakr called Bakr. But this has become, you know, he was well known with this kunya. So Abu Bakr is Qurashi, he's from Quraysh, radiallahu anhu, and he is Bani Taym ibn Murrah. Bani Taym ibn Murrah. And Murrah ibn Ka'ab is where Bani Taym and Bani Abd Munaf meet, or Bani Hisham meet. And Abu Bakr's nickname was Atiq was Siddiq. These two things. He had two nicknames. One is called Atiq, means the freed one. And As-Siddiq means the believer. Why was he called Atiq? Most of the scholars, they say, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, as Aisha radiallahu anhu says, he was called Atiq because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala freed him from the hellfire. So he's not going to the hellfire. Atiq. It's also said he was very handsome person, and that's why he was called Atiq. And Laqab al-Siddiq, the nickname of Siddiq, is the believer, the true believer, because he believed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Specifically, there was history or an event at the time of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in which the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Quraysh, I was taken to a night journey from Mecca to Baytul Maqdis, to the heavens, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Quraysh could not believe that. They were shocked to hear that. And they said, you went to Baytul Maqdis, the Masjid al-Aqsa, you went there. And you came back, and then you went to the heavens, and you met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you came back. And you came back. All of that in one night. And we go to Baytul Maqdis. And it takes us a month. A month to go and a month to come back. So they could not believe. And then they said, okay, describe the Masjid al-Aqsa, the mosque, describe in Qudus, describe it for us. So the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described for them the masjid, how it looked like, the simplest of the masjid, the doors of the masjid, all those things. And then they said, okay, about the description, you're right. You're right about the description. But we do not believe that you could go there overnight, then to the heavens and come back. We cannot believe that. So Abu Bakr came in that situation. When the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam left, Abu Bakr came to the Kaaba. And men from Quraysh who were questioning the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Abu Bakr, did you hear what your friend said today? And he said, what did he say? They told him that he said, he went to a night journey. In a night journey, he went to Baytul Maqdis and then to the heavens. And he came back to Mecca within the same night. Within the same night. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu calmly and confidently, he said, did he say that? They said, yes. That's what he said today. They were expecting from Abu Bakr to say, that is impossible, that cannot be the case, he did not say that, I don't believe that, they were expecting him to say that. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu said, if he said that, he is telling the truth. And I believe that. If he said it, I believe it. And they were shocked that Abu Bakr believed that. And he said, I believe even more than that. More strange to you than that. And they said, what is more than that? He said, the news of the heaven, I believed the news of the heaven coming to him in a blink of eye. خَبَرُ السَّمَاءِ يَأْتِيهِ فِي لَحْظَةٍ. The news of the heaven, that's revelation, wahi, the Quran, coming to the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a blink of eye. The blink of the eye. Like a second. So it is said that day he was called as-siddiq, the believer. So whenever you hear about Abu Bakr as-siddiq, that's what it means, as-siddiq. Also, Imam Bukhari radiallahu anhu reported, and Anas ibn Malik, for the narration of the Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sa'ida uhudan, wa Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman. فرجف بهم فقال أثبت أحد فإنما عليك نبي وصديق 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 وشهيدان. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, they climbed the mountain Uhud. The mount of Uhud. They climbed the mount of Uhud. And on the top of it, while they were on the top of it, the mountain of Uhud started shaking. Like a quick, like it was hit by a little quick earthquake. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Uthbut Uhud. O Uhud, stay calm. Stay calm. Uthbut. فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ نَبِيٌّ on you, on top of you, are a prophet, صديقٌ وصديقٌ, a believer, وشهيدان, and two martyrs. Two martyrs. That's Umar, who was martyr, and Uthman, who was also martyr. So, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم called him as صديق وصديق وصديق. Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه was born the year of the elephant. After 2 years of the year of the elephant, 2 years and 6 months. There are conflicting reports about the age of Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه compared to the age of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. Which one was older? Was it Abu Bakr? Was it the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم? They were close to each other. Some of the riwayat they say, and Abu Bakr was older than Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم about 2 years. Others say like this, and one says, and it was vice versa. The Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم was older than Abu Bakr about that period, like 2 years and a half. Because the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم was born Aam al-Fil, the year of the elephant. The year of the elephant is the year that Abraha, with his elephants from Abyssinia, and who was based at the time in Yemen, he attacked the Kaaba, and his intention was to destroy the Kaaba, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed him, destroyed his army and his elephants. So it's called the year of the elephant. The sifat of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was an abyad nahifan. Abyad means white, not like Caucasian, but he was an Arab. He was Arab. So it means like he was very much light skinned, like most of the Arabs. Nahifan, he was also a skinny man. He was not heavily built or things like that. He was a skinny man. And he used to put henna on his beard, radiallahu anhu. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when it comes to his heart and his characteristics, he was a very soft man, very kind man, rahiman, raqiq al-qalb. His heart was very soft. And he had very good manners. And he was very kind, radiallahu anhu. The Sahaba and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was the first one to believe the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of men. People are categorized or divided into groups. For example, the first one who accepted Islam, first woman who accepted Islam and believed in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Khadija radiallahu anha, his wife. The first man, adult, male, to accept the deen of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to believe in Allah and his messenger was Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. The first of the young men, or children you can say, was Ali ibn Abi Talib. So if you hear Khadija was the first one to believe the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it means of women. But generally, yes, Khadija was the first one, no doubt about that. As Hadith al-Bukhari indicates, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Khadija radiallahu anha and told her what happened to him, the squeeze and that he was frightened and scared. And Khadija believed him at the time. Even when the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not sure about what is happening and he was scared, Khadija believed that day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, an angel came to him and his message is white. She believed, she was the first believer. But when it comes to men, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr were friends. is what the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was revealed to. They were best friends. So he was the first one of men to believe Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's message. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he took the message of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very seriously. Very seriously. From day one. He took the message of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very seriously. And he started preaching and calling people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he went to his friends, like Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu. And Uthman ibn Affan, radiallahu anhu, accepted the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. He was a wealthy man and a businessman, and he supported the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and supported the Muslims with his wealth. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, whenever he sees a Muslim that is punished or tortured by Quraysh, he would and give them money to release that Muslim. If those Muslims punished were slaves, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu used to free them, buy them, and then free them. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu used to protect the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One day, Abu Bakr came radiallahu anhu, while Quraysh were fighting with the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, throwing things at him, trying to beat the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Abu Bakr intervened right away. And he said, "Ataqtuluna rajulan an yaqula rabbi Allah?" Are you killing a man only by saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is his Lord? Are you killing him for that? Only for that you're killing him? And then Quraysh turned away from the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to Abu Bakr. And they started beating him until he was unconscious. They beat him so bad until he was, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, was very unconscious. And he woke up late in the afternoon. And when his mother and his family and were around him. And when he woke up, he said, the first thing he said was, how is the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How is the Prophet of Allah? And they said, he is good. He's doing well. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, I will not rest. I will not eat. I will not drink anything until I see the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I make sure that he is okay. So they took him, basically they carried him. They carried him to the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he ate after when he saw the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam well and fine. He loved the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he gave by giving his life for the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for the protection of the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Some of the hadith that when Hijrah came, when the time of the Hijrah or migration from Mecca to Medina came, Abu Bakr, the best thing for Abu Bakr and that he wished for all the time was to go with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discusses that in the Quran. ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين أو the Muslims if you do not support the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported him already and gave him the victory Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was the second of two ثاني اثنين second of two when they were in the cave when he said to his friend do not worry Allah is with us لا تحزن do not worry Allah is with us and in صحيح البخاري and Muslim من حديث أنس بن مالك أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه is talking about this journey and he said I have looked at the feet of the Quraysh, Mushrikeen, on our heads. They were in the cave, and their feet were right at the mouth of the cave. And we were in the cave, he said, وَنَحْنُ فِي الْغَارِ نَظَرْتُ إِلَىٰ أَقْدَامِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ عَلَىٰ رُؤُوسِنَا وَنَحْنُ فِي الْغَارِ I looked at the feet of the Mushrikeen around the cave, and we were in the cave. فقلت يا رسول الله لو أن أحدهم نظر إلى قدميه أبصرنا تحت قدميه I said أو رسول الله if one of them were to look down at his feet he would have seen us and the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said يا أبا بكر ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما Oh Abu Bakr, what do you think of two? Allah is their third. What do you think of two people? And the third of them is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means Allah's support and victory is with these two. So they will not even see us. And if they see us, they will not be able to do anything to us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu also in that hijrah or in that migration from Mecca to Medina, he was with the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and when they went to the cave, Abu Bakr saw holes within in the cave. That is snakes and things coming out. So he covered it and put things in those holes except one. And then he put that on his feet to cover it. So something bit him from there. Something bites him from there. Snake or something, Allah knows. Scorpion or things like that. It was very painful. So Abu Bakr and was feeling the pain and tears came down and drops of tears fell on the face of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he was holding the head of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on his lap. So when that drop of tear fell down on the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's face, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam woke up. And he said, what happened? And Abu Bakr said, Ludightu, I was bitten. And then the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and stroke his hand on that place that was Abu Bakr was bitten from. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured him instantly, right away. When the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr were walking from Mecca to Medina in that same journey, Abu Bakr, the Nabi would walk or on the back of his camel, will ride his camel. Both of them were riding the camel. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would look forward. Abu Bakr would look all the time, left and right, back and forth. Checking the situation, looking if people are approaching, things like that. And constantly he was on guard, guarding the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is why even the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, they had that and respect for Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu, and they believed, all of them believed, that they could not compete with Abu Bakr radhiyallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Umar says radhiyallahu anhuma, at the time of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we used to put people in their levels. We were given a choice to place people according to their positions. And then we would choose first Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman, and then we become quiet. We'll stop there. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there, and he would not comment on it. Which means that is taqrir. In hadith, there are three branches of the hadith, or three ways that hadith comes. One is called al-aqwal, words. The other one is al-a'mal, actions of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The other one is called al-taqarir, or al-taqrir, or al-iqrar, which is the approval of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hears people saying something or doing something, and he does not object to that thing, that is part of the deen. Because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never keeps quiet from wrong things. When people are doing wrong things, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would not be quiet about it. So his silence, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's silence on a specific matter, whether it is words or actions, that silence is approval of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it's part of the hadith. So which means the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam approved when the Sahaba said, the first of this nation is Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman. That is the approval from the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi Abu Bakr, he stayed with the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and at all levels, in all events, all battles, all journeys that the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam took, and he contributed to spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with whatever he had, whether it was and his wealth, his family, and his level in the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim. Abu Bakr used all those things to spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Bakr was one of the most knowledgeable of the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim. And he used to even give fatwa at the time of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even that means with the approval of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Bukhari and Muslim narrated from hadith Abu Hurairah, قال بعثني أبو بكر الصديق في الحجة التي أمره عليها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل حجة الوداع في رهط يؤذنون في الناس يوم النحر لا يحج بعد العام مشرك ولا يطوف بالبيت عريان. أبو هريرة says, أبو بكر sent me in the Hajj that النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and gave him the commands or the orders to be the head of the journey of that Hajj before the Hajjatul Wada. Hajjatul Wada is the Hajj the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. So Abu Bakr did that Hajj before Hajjatul Wada. So Abu Bakr asked Abu Huraira to say that there is no mushrik, a polytheist, who can perform Hajj after this year. Because Mushrikeen al-Arab, or Mushrikeen al-Quraysh, or al-Arab, or غيرهم, the mushrikeen of the Quraysh and others, all Arabs, used to do Hajj, although they were mushrikeen. So Abu Bakr gave that fatwa, no mushrik or polytheist can come to the Hajj after this year. And also, the Quraysh or some other Arabs used to make the tawaf while naked, no clothes at all, men and women, some of them at least, because they believed that, and they should not wear the clothes that they had sins with while they are doing tawaf of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we also established that practice. وَلَا يَطُوفُ بِالْبَيْتِ عُرْيَانٌ. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he paid all his wealth, one of the battles, or one of the journeys, the journey of Tabuk. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu paid all his wealth, and how that came about. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu says, أَمَرَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنْ نَتَصَدَّقَ فوافق ذلك مالا فقلت اليوم أسبق أبا بكر إن سبقته يوما. Umar says the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked us and or commanded us to pay sadaqah, and it came, that order or that commandment came at a time when I had some wealth. It coincided with me having some wealth. So I said, today I am going to beat Abu Bakr in this competition. I want to pass Abu Bakr today. قال فجئت بنصف مالي. He said, I came with a half of my wealth, half of it. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أبقيت لأهلك. Oh Umar, what did you leave for your family? This is what you brought today, but what did you leave for your family? قلت مثله. I said, like this one, half. I left half for them. Exactly like this. وأتى أبو بكر بكل ما عنده فقال يا أبا بكر ما أبقيت لأهلك. And Abu Bakr came with all what he had. So the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Oh Abu Bakr, what did you leave for your family? And Abu Bakr said, أَبْقَيْتُ لَهُمُ اللَّهَ أَبْقَيْتُ لَهُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَبْقَيْتُ لَهُمُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. I left for them Allah and His Messenger. Allahu Akbar. So قَالَ عُمَر. Then Umar said, قُلْتُ. Umar said, والله لا أسبقه إلى شيء أبدا. والله I can never beat him in anything. I can never beat Abu Bakr in anything. I cannot win against Abu Bakr at all. And alhamdulillah, after that, he got also wealth. Abu Bakr was the most beloved person by the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, most beloved man of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu says, as this hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Amr ibn As and to a place to do something for the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Was it delivering a message or collecting sadaqah or doing something else or going on reconnaissance? Allah knows. When he came back, Amr ibn As, to the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Nabi welcomed him. He welcomed him warmly and nicely, and he said to him very nice words. That Amr ibn As thought, Rasulullah loves him more than anyone else. And that was the characteristic of the Rasulullah. He would welcome people. Be nice to them. Be kind to them. Use nice words. Until that person, the strange person, thinks that he is loved by the Rasulullah. So Amr ibn As, although he accepted Islam lately, recently, those days, by the way the Rasulullah welcomed him and was nice to him, he thought that the Nabi loved him more than anyone else. So he asked him a question. قال, he said, أَيُّ النَّاسِ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. Which one of the people you love the most? And he said, قال, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Aisha. I love Aisha the most. Aisha was the wife of the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Also the daughter of Abu Bakr Siddiq. You know, some of us, if we're told, which who do you love the most? They shy away, men, they shy away from saying, I love my wife. They shy away from that, which is not right. And also women nowadays, they do shy away from saying, I love my husband, he's very good to me, things like that. But the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says that Aisha is the one he loves the most. قَالَ قُلْتُ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ. He said, then I said, of men, I'm talking about men, I'm not talking about women. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, قَالَ أَبُوهَا. Her father is the second most and beloved one to me. I love Abu Bakr and more than anyone else of men. So inshallah, the time will not permit us to say about the rest of the story of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And there is a lot of and the history of Abu Bakr to be said and to be told. And inshallah, we'll save that for the next class. صلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. So any questions, inshallah? I think we have a few minutes.
ما شاء الله. السلام عليكم شيخ يوسف. جزاك الله خير.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. بارك الله فيك أخي.
عام السلام أشكر رمى. وحنا هاي.
الحمد لله.
ذاتك درارت القريسين القرصان ذي الله درار والبيد ويدي.
ولا لو كوي جوابنا وحير إن شاء الله ولا الله هذا محاضرة الله سعود لجيسنا يجي إن شاء الله تعالى هدي one or two questions and 10 كيس الصلاة كانوا صاحا أرضي دي والديار شيخنا والديار هذا نجلينا. marka aan hal su'aal ama loo su'aalo walaalihi hadda muhaadarada dhigaysanay khaasatan een wiilasha yar yar iyo gabdhaha yar oo hadda aan dhigaysanay hadii jira is there any questions oo sheekh uu weydiinayo insha Allah soo dhawaada I think Abdul Nasir uu yara mashquul marka wax su'aal qabo hadii jira insha Allah ku soo saar kelimada sheekh hadda uu dhahay
Inshallah, if you have
the brothers, if you have any questions, the youth kids and the people who participate, if you have any question for Sheikh Yusuf, inshallah, you can press star one and then ask your question, inshallah. بقدر من غشاء.
اسمعي سفيان ما شاء الله. ويا شيخ يوسف كله وحنو ملاينا يا وا ولا لا حسال مقام جزاك الله خير إلى سبحانه وتعالى مزيان
أمين أخ بارك الله فيك
بارك الله فيك
أي شاء الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته هي أستاذ سلاد إن شاء الله تعالى يرضي لي في صلاة إنجليش كا سؤال هذا إن شاء الله
جزاك الله خير أخي
معنا سلاد يا
هي أخي وكجرة هي
أوه ما شاء الله ما شاء الله حيه تفضل بارك الله فيك
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد